So call in your very best friends. Your very best friends. Your very best friends. So call in your very best friends while I go out to play. On the mountain stands a lady. Who she is, I do not know. All she wants is gold and silver. All she wants is a nice young man.
Now remember, I'll be back in 6 months, no more. And then we'll go somewhere wonderful, where the rain has warm hands and the sea.
I'll be waiting for you, Mum.
And don't let on you're a Catholic. Paddies always get the worst.
Can you march?
What? Now?
I'll show you then. Wilson, give us a march.
Get on, pal.
I had a good job for 45 bob, but I left. I left. I had a good job for 45 bob, but I left. I left. I had a good knowledge of your left. I had a good job for 45 bob, but I left. I left. I had a good job for 45 bob, but I left. I left. I left.
Good! I'm here.
Down, right down.
Shut up, but you don't know.
Quiet, Gilly.
Look at the spade there, froggies.
Round it, round it.
Look at that, look at that. It's a bit thin on the end. We couldn't borrow a few of our little paddy friends to make up the numbers.
I doubt it.
Go away!
nothing to do with you. Step back there. 1951.
This is split. Fetch me another from the cupboard.
That's the last one.
We must order a new batch from the Sisters of Mercy.
Can you hear me now? Wilkes, can you hear me?
What's the flippin' boot for? Do you mean off, Abby?
Right, oh, you're next. Right, I'll pull you up.
So you are a Paddy then, yeah?
I'm not.
Don't bear something, I'm Catholic. Only I'm not a Paddy, that's all. I wouldn't want to be. They had the Germans in the war.
No, we didn't. We was neutral. I mean, they was.
You was not. Your lot left the lights on in Dublin. So the German planes come up the Irish Sea, turned right at Dublin, and came over here and bombed the crap out of Liverpool. That's what my dad reckons, and he should know. Him and my mum, they know everything.
Well, how come you're not with them, then, if they're that great?
My dad's in Germany, right? He's a spy on our side, of course.
How do you know?
He wears a tuxedo.
Bet you can't even hit that ball.
Wait, I can!
What about your mum?
I wasn't even halfway.
She had this long green dress. All shiny. Maggie says she was a spy too, but she never let on. I remember sitting on her knee, nearly slipping off, all the time on account of this shiny dress of hers. All shiny it was. And I remember her calling me Albert. Me, it was Albert. I like that. Albert.
What's he up to?
Bloody heck, deaf aid!
Is it done as well as deaf?
Nah. I just think he's a fish.
The Empire Club is now in session.
The what is what?
The Empire Club. I'm Prime Minister, Wilson's Chancellor. You can be Minister of State if you play your cards right.
Avatar.
Alf. The book.
He's making fish faces again.
Bert, you read it.
No. I want to hear Alf read it.
The circuit?
Circuit.
The circuit of...
The circuit of pavilions that lie in a rough semicircle upstream from Unkerford Bridge tells the story of the land of Britain and the things the British have derived from their land. The exhibition celebrates the preeminent achievements of British men and women in mapping and charting the globe, exploring the heavens, and investigating the nature and structure of the universe. All hail to the Skylon, symbol of British science.
All hail to the Skylon.
All hail to the Dome of Discovery, symbol of British engineering and progress.
All hail to the Dome of Discovery.
Hands up, anyone who can tell me the name of a country in the Commonwealth.
England?
Yes, perhaps somewhere a little further away.
Scotland. India!
Canada!
Ireland!
Africa!
Parts of it.
America!
Not anymore, thank goodness.
New Zealand!
Yes! And somewhere rather large near New Zealand, with lots of sheep.
Australia!
That's the ticket! You know, when I was your age, all those places were part of what we called the British Empire. Countries that belonged to the Empire were coloured red on the maps. It seemed to me, as a boy, that almost everywhere worth owning was coloured red. These days, of course, we don't call it the Empire. We call it the Commonwealth. But it's still an empire in many ways, with people all over the world speaking the language of Shakespeare, governing themselves along the lines of our great parliament in Westminster, administering justice using English law. It's an empire of ideas, free speech, fair play, and goodwill. Now, this is where you come in. Thousands of British children, just like you, have already done their bit for the Commonwealth, traveling to far-off places where the white, English-speaking population needed building up. Now I'm extending the challenge to you. Who here would like to help us keep the British flag flying in these far-off places? Well then, who of you is ready for an adventure? A really grand adventure. Splendid, splendid. Now I want you to form into three groups. Those of you who wish to go to Rhodesia, to Australia, and Canada. There, there, and there.
Send us away, do you?
Right, hold her down.
No, Bill, what are you doing? No. No. It's good.
She's satisfactory.
Nothing to be frightened of. It's just a precaution.
Is little Laura brought with her?
No, not just a little. You know, having your tonsils out, but it's just like Scott of the Antarctic having his appendix out before he went to the South Pole.
Brother, have you had your tonsils out?
Afterwards, you can have an ice cream.
Ice cream? Am I next?
That's all right, it only takes a few moments.
What's Lily doing with blood on her mouth? What's that?
Don't take a flat on your back.
Have a look at the Festival of Britain.
It's not shut, didn't it? About a month back, longer.
What?
End of the summer. It's just an hole in the ground now, so I hear.
Even the skyline?
It's probably melted down.
Will we be stopping there anyhow?
Our first landfall's Lisbon, I think.
Steam, or I have your carriage on. Now, what's it to be? You can kiss me, blooming ass! Blooming ass! Fucking! Fucking! Fucking!
getting burst your stitches. I'll do as you're told and lie down.
When my mum comes back from London and finds out what
you've done... hold your breath waiting to hear from her. She won't be back.
So you know.
For a start, little smart Alec. Your mother never left Liverpool. She never got any further than Paradise Street. Frankly, she isn't fit to be a mother at all. Little piece of filth! They can scrub you and scrub you till the flesh comes off, but you're never enough for trash! Lock it.
Is there a porthole?
Perhaps. You keep your head in mind. Want to have a look?
Wow!
Do you see the white circle with lines going through and around it? On the hull near the water?
Yeah.
Do you know what it is?
No.
It's the Plimsoll line. It was invented last century by Samuel Plimsoll. It shows how low a ship can ride on the water before it's overloaded. Something greedy ship owners used to do.
Why?
Insurance, mainly. They wanted the ships to sink. What did they care how many sailors were drowned? They came from below the Plimsoll line. I'm trying to write about it. A book, perhaps, if I'm lucky.
Where are all the different lines?
Well, in different parts of the world, the water's different.
How can the water be different?
Well, it's all to do with the amount of salt. Well, on the Dead Sea, for example, the water's so salty you could float all day on a sheet of newspaper. You couldn't sink if you tried.
Where's the line for the Dead Sea?
On the tip of its hull, I suppose. You know, a ship on the Dead Sea would stand right up out of the water. It would go sailing across the surface, like an ice skate, balanced on its blade.
Shh. Shh. Dead Sea.
And say they've sent me to flipping Australia, but I'll get back somehow. And tell Aunt Vera, she's to tell me mum to keep in touch with her. So when I get me new address...
Slow down. I'm not a racehorse, you know.
The engine stopped.
I must be coming into port then.
Hurry up then.
Over there! Can we ride the camel? Can we see the Nile?
Don't know.
Brother, do you get the post office over here?
Yes, I suppose you know it.
Yes, I
Well, on the way to the pyramids, I'm going to post this letter.
Yes. I'm afraid none of your children are going to be going to the pyramids. Yeah, Captain says all children have to stay on the ship.
Why?
I don't know, something about the cholera scare.
Well, will you post this letter for me?
Aunt Vera with the blue hair, 50 or 70, white something, street, Manchester, England. If you promise to be good while I'm gone.
Oh, cross me off. You too, go on.
No pyramids, Wills. We're stuck on a boat. If you see the Rosetta Stone, will you say hello for me?
What the heck? I won't go either.
What?
But what about me letter?
Oh, yes. Well, Right.
I'll tell you what's out the friggin' window.
Yeah!
Right. There's people marching with torches held up high above their heads.
Where are they going?
They're heading towards a great pyramid of Cheops.
Eh?
All the high priests and the nobles and the pharaoh's wives.
And the slaves.
Yeah, and the slaves. A gathering for the festival. The festival of Egypt. This Cleopatra's needle is all lit up, like the skyline. And there's some pavilions over there. And there's a great display of fireworks. And there's a great roast pig on a spit. And here comes the pharaoh himself. He's got an eagle on his arm. And he's drinking some deepest red from a big cup.
Blood?
Yeah, that's it. And now he's finished drinking. He's calling for his chief scientist, Ptolemy,
who looks at the stars for a while. And orders Pharaoh's guards to bring the royal trireme.
The what, what?
That's a big boat with three sets of oars, one below the other. And it's pulled by slaves. With their hands tied to the oars, and with
ropes as thick as your wrists.
Yeah. And Tommy's going to the side of the boat, and now he's painting a circle on it with a line through the middle to show how high the boat can float in the water when it gets out to sea. And now the pharaoh's saying, put all the bad slaves down in the bottom of the boat, down below the plimsoll land. And give them one lousy porthole, too high up the friggin' wall, and too scratched to see anything through it.
From the Sphinx?
From its nose, according to the little blighter who sold it to me.
My letter? Did you post it?
No, I ate it. Yeah. I got this for you.
goddess Ibis. I've seen it in Wilson's Ebig annual.
No, it's not. It's a lava bit. You knew, didn't you? You knew I'd been dreaming of them.
What are you up to? You just want to be the captain? What are you up?
Shut up, what are you up?
Come on. Be quiet, everybody. What are you up? God, you've seen all day.
There we go.
Creator and Redeemer of all the faithful, grant to the soul of thy servant Alfred full remission of all offence, that through the help pious supplications
full fathom five, thy father lies, of his bones are coronated. Those were pearls that were his eyes, nothing of him that doth fade, but doth suffer a sea change into something rich and strange. Come unto these yellow sands, and then take hands, curtsied when you haven't kissed the wild wind with. Put it fleetly here and there, while sweet sprites bear the burden. Full fathom five, thy father lies.
Do you think maybe I was like them flowers? Tiny, floating off across the sea. Fish tickling his toes. He won't know what's happening no more. Don't cry for him.
I'm not. It's for us. Your mum's gone. We'll never see the Mersey again.
Well, you are the one who wanted to come on this flipping trip. gonna get back there. Don't ask me how or when, but we'll do it, Bert. Whatever it takes. Just as long as we stick together.
How can we? They're not sending us Catholics and new proddies to the same places.
Then I'll own up. I'll tell them how I look after all.
You really are?
Our Father who art in heaven. Who? Not flipping witch. And we'll tell them we're brother and sister. And they'll have to keep us together.
I like the idea of having a sister, yeah? Of course, I may already have one in Germany. Like, if your mother and father met up behind enemy lines and messed around a bit, you know. But just in case, we'll tell them we're from the same family, eh?
God, just think, you've got a man in Germany.
What about your own mum?
I can't decide about her. I think she lies a lot of the time.
Well, we'll give him a life for a lie. Can Wilson be enough on it too?
All right. At least he doesn't jabber his head off. Oh, Bert.
Yeah, Lily.
Oh, Jeff ain't.
Aching about your man this and your man that.
No.
No. Because your wonderful man signed this form saying we can send you wherever we like.
Crap.
She never wants to see you again in her life.
How do you know?
There's her signature.
Where?
Right there. Now get back there and on the green bus.
Okay, this is where you sleep. Curfew starts in 10 minutes. Stay in the hut till assembly at 5 a.m. tomorrow.
Hang on. When do we eat?
You'll get some in the morning.
But we haven't had anything since the boat.
Oh, God.
Or a wash.
Didn't think you pommies knew how. Now in, all of you.
Thank you.
You don't call that fool, do you?
Hey, leave him alone. He can't hear you.
What?
He's deaf.
Jesus.
Yeah. You tell me what you want him to do, and I'll make sure he understands.
All right. You tell the little prick to go and fuck himself. We haven't got all day. Put your backs into it. Move it! Come on! Himself.
Ow! What are we gonna have? Friggin' shoes back, eh?
You don't. Just off the top of your feet up, won't you?
You've got boots.
I earned them. You can tell Thicker is to put it back up. Properly this time. Yeah. Oh, get him, David. Come on, you little scout. Shit.
Get him, David.
Bitch!
Come on. Get him, David.
Get him, David.
Oh, come on. Shit. Come on.
Bees have been around much, much longer than man. And they'll be around long after we've all killed each other off.
Don't you ever fight?
Not each other. Each bee works for the good of the hive. They're even special undertaker bees.
How did he know who does what? Can they talk?
They make these funny little noises. Except because bees don't have ears, they have to listen with their whole bodies. Feel vibrations coming up through the comb. Or do a little dance that contains a message all the other little bees can understand.
Wouldn't it be easier to have ears?
This is where the bees have been feeding for the past few days, so all the bees, even this little fellow who's not been out of the hive, have shared the information. Stored in his body like an inbuilt compass. Open the jar. Okie dokie, follow that bee. Where's he headed, boy? Where?
The hive! He knows it's my home!
I've done what I can. We'll try and get him to eat.
Come on.
Listen. If you can hear this. I don't know why David picks on you. But I've talked to Brother Jerome. He's going to look after you as much as he can. Maybe that'll help. Look, you mustn't give up. We're going to find Lily. And the three of us will get back home eventually. We'll fall upwards. Round the stomach of the world. Fall and fall. Till we're back by our mercy. I mean, ride the elevated railway. And count all the cranes on the docks. And you can swim in a canal. If the slide's not too bad. We're hookwells. By these invisible wires. To all the junk and dirt in that river. We'll be drawn back there by a dirty little compass inside us. So we can't ever be lost. If the bees can do it, we can too. I know we can.
Right above here, there'll be a great stone cross, visible for miles.
Can I have a go? Nick off.
Give him a go. Here. This is the focal point. The altar goes here.
Three most interesting things you know about history.
The history of the world, you mean, brother?
That'll do.
Well, the Sumerians drank beer through a straw, and the Pharaoh's servants got buried alive with him inside the pyramids after he kicked the bucket. And? The man who helped decode the Rosetta Stone also showed how light moves in waves.
Where do you learn all this? Not from Brother Matthew, surely.
That's all in Wilson's ear again, the old brother. You should be there.
Come on. Smoke out.
Or we'll have to smoke.
We are. Think of her.
If you can't build a pyramid, I suppose a church is the next best thing. I wish it had the dome.
Why?
Because of the Dome of Discovery. You know, the Festival of Britain.
What's that you got?
It's a bit of the Sphinx's nose.
Guard it closely if it's the real thing.
Yeah, it is. Brother Matthew says so.
There's no reason this couldn't have been quarried at the time of the pharaohs. Very old sandstone. Quite porous. You know what porous means?
No.
Through the rock, there are tiny holes that let in water and air. But more than that, they soak up the lives of everyone that comes into contact with the rock. Great men with visions of better worlds. Ordinary men that keep the wheels of this one turning. You should keep this in your pocket. Maybe you'll rub off on it. Be like a diary, a bank. All the great moments of your life held in permanent trust.
Like, your church will be for you when it's built.
Guys reckons that when it rains, like, it's gonna be a swimming pool.
You didn't believe David, did you?
He did.
Come on, Wheels, it's tea time. It's nothing but a great big hole in the ground. It's not a pool, you donkey.
Lady Pearl. Lady Pearl. Lady Pearl.
Just stop that! Stop it! Stop it!
Go!
Med bait. Let him have it, son.
Can't wait. Let him have it, mate.
Everyone on the toes.
There's a half a bloody mile inside the crease.
You're the blind one, pal.
Do you want to lose something before they all kill each other?
Good punch up never hurt anyone.
Nor a broken jaw, nor a broken nose, neither, I suppose. Just so long as it doesn't put too serious a dent in your workforce.
Meaning?
Come on, hit him!
The way you're using these children, it's nothing short of slave labor.
While I'm rolling in dough for my pains.
These kids are no better off, no better fed, no better clothed here than they were in England. The only difference is you're working them after death instead of...
Instead of what? Teaching them adverbial clauses of time.
Half of them can't even read or write their own names. They're not being prepared to face life in any way. They're cut off from the world. Home. The influence of women. I mean, they haven't even got shoes.
Women? What would they need women for when they've got you?
David.
What?
Just get on the wheel.
Hey, boy.
Should we finish, eh, brother?
You don't stop here, boy. We'll build the seminary next.
Yeah?
Then a college with a great library and a giant dome over the main reading room. Held up our keystone instead of a cross. You can help me think the keystone. Come on, you blinking idiot. We haven't got all day.
Blinking idiots.
You can be the keystone, son.
Yahoo!
Is this what you're putting on the wall?
More or less. I'll have a bit more space for background and whatnot.
Can you shove a rivet in?
Possibly.
And docks and cranes. And a big cathedral on a hill.
Anything else?
Live birds. Kiss a couple of them too.
I'll do my best. I sent young Wilson packing when I realised how late it was. He'll turn up. Probably fallen asleep somewhere.
Aren't you going to bed?
Old owl like me doesn't need much sleep. Oh, I've given you your docks and cranes.
Oh, grape.
And a cathedral. And just for fun, I put in a bee box.
That's creepy. Wilson must be scared of them bees. He never wants to go down there, no.
That's no good. David was scared of the bees when I had him. And they could tell. That's why I got stuck. Strange boy. The poison's in his system now. One more sting and... he'll be a goner, as they say, in the classics.
You mean, dead?
As the proverbial. Now, what shall we do about Madame?
Can you give her yellow hair? And big blue eyes? And a bright red mouth.
Why?
Just cause.
What are you doing out?
Looking for Wilson. He ain't come back from work. What's wrong, mate? What's happened? Was it David? Did David hit you? Tell me. You need a doctor or something?
Come in.
Is the lad going to be all right?
Oh, yes. Yes, provided he's decently looked after.
Of course.
There is something else that troubles me rather more. This young boy has lacerations to the backs of his legs.
Recent?
Well, not very.
England, then. I can't account for everything that happened to these children before they arrived here.
Well, there is some indication that this boy has been interfered with.
Exactly what are you saying, Alan?
Well, nothing conclusive without...
Surely this warrants a further...
Would you be raising this matter?
I thought I'd talk it over with you first, of course.
I appreciate that, Alan.
Well, I'll leave it up to you then.
You can rely on me. I'll keep you informed.
You must be very patient with Wilson. Be kind to him. Look after him.
What's wrong with him?
Somebody's done a very bad thing to him. It might make him nervous about being touched. Even even by his friends, just in the course of normal events. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Like the pig. It'll be all right, won't it?
In time.
Scouse on her.
Scouse on her.
Nothing when you came here. You'd be nothing if you left.
Someone gonna make your book?
No, not exactly. There's a publisher. He's offered me a job proofreading.
Is that where you prove you can read?
No, not exactly. It's where you check new books for spelling mistakes and the like.
You'd be good at that.
But I haven't got much time, and there's about a dozen things I'd like to explain to you about
why. Why aren't you taking this? Why not?
Bert, will you listen to me?
Don't you want it no more?
No. It was my ticket once out of a family I didn't much like. But it's not taking me anywhere. Anymore. You and Wilson, will you look me up when you leave?
I don't know when that'll be.
You were going to tell me about leaving, weren't you? You weren't going to just slink off.
with you now?
No. He travels fastest who travels alone.
You, look after each other now, huh? I'm sorry. I didn't know how to do it better for you.
Not saying much.
Just thinking.
What about?
Nothing.
Wilson's going to be all right from now on. Taking care of the problem.
I've asked Brother Jerome to give Mary blue eyes and a nose. Like this. It's funny. Filling in all the gaps and watching the whole person coming out through the plaster, isn't it? Don't you reckon? Like seeing a pattern in a jigsaw.
Or remembering something from when you were a kid. It's just being, what's the word? Happy. I suppose you're too young to understand that.
But I do. It's like the time I still had my mum and dad. I used to be able to see all of it. Like at the pictures or something. But now, it's all fallen out of my head. Just little bit. By little bit. And it's just a flipping great hole where my folks used to be, with only a hat or a tie or a dress in it. No faces. I can't hear their voices no more. Sin. It's the middle of the night, you daft bugger.
Swimming pool. That was Adelaide David's. Do you hear me? Now go back to sleep. Okay?
Who's there? Is someone there? Is someone there?
Four goods round the stomach of the world, four and four to a back by our Maisie. Home, Wills. Home.
Requiem materialum dominus atrium nostrium, dominum patricium domine. Et lux perpetua luceae
aeum. It is to arrive.
In sanctus pius in aeternum, quia pius as. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you, Father. Perhaps you can say a mass for that during the week.
Sorry, Duffy. I'm sorry. I didn't listen to you when you needed me. Maybe I never did half as well as you.
I think I might have some small idea how you feel about your friend. Life can be full of sad things. We're often forced to say goodbye when we least want to. As if our hearts were running some stupid obstacle course. Always chasing after what we can't possibly have. It's hard to imagine why God made us that way. But he must have had a reason. We won't forget Wilson, will we?
says you can come out now. You've got to cook tea.
Tell her to cook it. Lazy cow.
Lily. Did you really say that word?
What word?
You know.
Go on, say it. You're dead scared, aren't you?
Am not.
Say it.
Fuck.
It's not fuck. It's fuck.
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 Fuck, 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 fuck.
Fuck, 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 fuck.
Is this it?
1 H.
And what does she get? Oops! Silly me. Langton Double Bank Canada. Duh!
Lily, let me.
You'll catch it, Lily O'Mara.
Oh, shut up, Mary B.
Squib, squib, Mary B. Think you're going to shut the thing.
Well, I'm not playing.
I am.
Dummy dumb, cottage mum needs a cracker up a bum.
You want to spend the night in the outside lab, do you? You like the dark, don't you?
No! Up here you come! Fucking come!
I understand you threw a chop at Mrs. Dunn. Several chops.
She's a cow.
Chop seems appropriate then. Get your dress up.
Ashwood Home has a proud tradition of taking in abandoned and unwanted girls and sending them back into the world as useful citizens. One among these will fail to do us proud in their new placements. The providing of comfortable, clean and economic households. Now, some of you, this is a new country, and we hope that you'll continue to deserve and to embrace the many opportunities it opens for you. Girls? Thank you, Mrs. Bird.
From far and near we
beach.
There'll be no one who talks like me no more.
You don't want us to stay here until we're all old and dried up like sister, do you? Where do you go?
Orange sister said. They grow apples there.
They grow sheep where I'm going.
Sheep don't grow. They just... Ah.
They used to. They grow roots right out of the feet. And keep on growing until they're as big as maples. And then you can climb up them by the wall, like Rapunzel. And when you get right to the top, you can see for miles and miles. Right out to sea. Sometimes, you can even see islands.
Daft.
Well, it could be too for all I know. Have you ever seen a sheep except with gravy on them?
No.
Well, there you are then.
I hate apples.
Fancy calling a place orange and growing apples there. They're all soft down here.
Goodbye, Lily.
Contract of employment. 12 months. Try not to disgrace us too much.
Sister, there's funny bug things in your hair. You used to watch your hygiene.
Isn't here.
I'm afraid a number of the girls are no longer with us.
But I said I'd be back in 6 months and I'm here. I've written and written. You knew I was coming back. Well, what have you done with Lily? Where is she?
Your daughter's been adopted, Mrs. O'Mara. We had some trouble tracing you, despite help from the police. They seem to have some knowledge of your line of work.
You haven't told Lily any of this. What have you told her?
Only enough to ease her mind about moving on. She's been placed with a good family. It's in Ireland, funnily enough.
Well, I want to see her. I want to get her back.
I'm afraid that's no longer a legal possibility for you, Mrs. O'Mara. I'm not even permitted to tell you where she is.
Well, you don't have to. Don't worry about it, because I'll find her myself. I'll track her down.
That would not be easy. Lily goes by a new name. Her birth date's been changed. Standard procedure.
You haven't heard the last of this.
Not really. It's for the best, don't you think? What kind of life could you give her?
Can I ask you something? Are you a mother, Mrs. Lang?
No.
No. Oh, no, I didn't think you were.
Thank you.
I haven't finished with that.
Dad, these chops are gritty.
Tom, Spuds.
Don't worry about the old man. Treats everyone like shit. Especially when they're eating out of house and home. Didn't they feed you in the orphanage?
Only on bits of shoe leather and jellyfish. What happened to you, Mum?
I died when I was a kid. Does that make me an orphan too? Well, eat up. But don't get fat on me, will you? And stop calling me sir. The old man, sir.
Ghosts get old, Mum?
No. They stay exactly the same forever.
Why do they?
It's like they're mirrors of themselves. On the other side, they don't want to forget.
I'm never being a ghost then.
Why is that?
Because I'd still be chewing my fingernails, wouldn't I?
How's Lily Marlene today?
Hiya, Hardy.
Got the kettle on for me?
What the flippin' heck's that?
It's a cicada shell.
This one's lost a leg.
He's flown out of that bit there. And that's the bit he leaves behind. Clever, isn't it?
Is that clever? Don't know what edible things are in there, do I?
Do you want me to cut the wood for you? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Yeah, all right. Just a bit. Don't they feed you here? Those fingernails are a disgrace, Missy.
I hate this place.
Oh, it's not too bad as places go.
The food's all right, but it's got no water. And all you can smell is dust and sheep shite.
You stuck your head in a bag of blood and bone lately?
Back home you can smell the water.
Oh yeah? What's Liverpool water smell of?
Tea. Tobacco. Coal. Boats. Sailors. And shite. our Bert used to say, you can tell which part of town the poo comes from, just by sniffing.
Who's Bert?
My brother.
Oh, yeah?
He's at a place called St. Bede's, near Sydney. Do you know it?
No, can't say I do.
Well, anyway, as soon as I get out of this sump, I'm going to find him, and we're going home. I'm going to have a room in this dead lovely corporation block called Jerrod Gardens, with a refrigerator on the top floor so we can see right over to the lava beds.
Your mum and dad both dead?
Yeah, they're dead. Both of them.
What are you up to?
Nothing.
What you just put in the oven?
Think I'm a thief now, do you?
Well, now I don't know, are you? What? They're for Grace.
Well, they're never for the boys, are they?
Well, you should have asked. I'll bring you some if you want them.
And I'm going to pay for them, swap them for me rags.
Well, don't they pay you anything out here?
Oh, go away. You're just like them. You think I'm a little piece of thieving English muck? Well, I'm better than the lot of yous.
How long were you going to cook them for? I'll see you next week, Your Highness.
Kiss me, so.
He probably does. You're a very beautiful girl.
No.
Yes, you are. And men will want to kiss you. Someday you might want to kiss one of them back.
And what happens then if I kiss them back?
Oh. Oh, well, now. That. It's the eighth wonder of the world.
I brought you something. It's a lava bird. H for Harry. I failed needlework. I failed everything.
It's very beautiful.
Where have you been? Been looking for you all afternoon.
I mean, Strife. I've got to do the cleaning and make up the rooms.
Wait. Brought you a present.
Hello. Where did you come from? Where's your mammy?
Found him. Mother must have got lost. Happy Christmas.
Ned, I've got to go.
There you go, Maddie.
The cleaning.
You just sit there. It's like dandelion.
Ned, the cleaning. I've got to go.
No one will notice you're not there. Come on, please.
Don't.
You're so pretty.
No, don't.
I won't hurt you.
No. Don't.
I won't hurt you. Swear.
Don't.
Please.
I'll scream.
Lily.
No.
Lily. Lily.
I'll kill you.
I wasn't going to hurt you.
I'll kill you.
Where?
Where the bloody hell have you been? Look at this. There's nothing for tea. The rooms haven't been made.
Your flipping fucking son's been jumping all over me. That's where I've been. You're a bully. Same as the lot of you. Ask him. Go on, ask him. You ask him where I've been. You ask him what he tried to do to me.
Shut up! I didn't touch her.
Liar! And a murderer!
Do you want a thrashing? Do you? She's been with the shearers all day.
You'll have to go. First train in the morning. I can't have you leading the men on. And don't think you can come running back here looking for money when you're in trouble. Pack your things.
I never did nothing!
It's not what you did. It's what you are.
Harry!
Sydney. Straight to that kid's home and report bloody Brogan for this.
Not Ashwood. I'm not going back there. I'm going to see Bert, Harry. We can find St. Bede's, can't we? It's got to be somewhere near Sydney. Harry?
Yeah. Yeah, it shouldn't be too hard to find.
Far from their camp. Wherever you are, either at home or away, in snow or in
sunshine. She talks dead posh, doesn't she?
Bloody Poms! You can't help yourselves, can you?
Happy Christmas, Lorne. This is Lily. Gave her a lift down to Sydney. Come meet the kids, Lil.
Out the back. Damien! Gabby!
How's school, Gabby?
Good. Damien, did you thank your father for the cricket bat?
He'll thank me in his own time, Lorne.
Why don't you two go and show Lily the backyard? I want to talk to your father for a minute.
Yeah, go on. Show Lily the cubby. Got your nose.
Bit young, isn't she?
Jesus, Lorna. Don't be ridiculous. She's only a kid. I'm helping her out.
You're much older than your own. Harry, we might have to change things about when you see Gabby and Damien. Make it only birthdays or something.
Oh, yeah? Why's that?
I met someone else.
Did you leave your family?
I drove the car off the road with the kids in it. That's how Damien lost his eye. I was drunk.
But why'd you live so far away?
I don't know. I grew up out there. The place always seemed to be on my side, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Is that enough water for you?
Yep.
Sydney water. What's it smell of?
Shite. And it's coming from over there.
And it's rich people's shite.
Posh shite?
Mm-hmm. Looking down its nose, shite.
Help it up, you bum, shite.
Wash your mouth out with soap, shite, if you're not careful.
Do you know in the war, Liverpool was all blacked out? But Dublin was lit up like a Christmas tree, so the German pilots could find out where they were. And then they see the water shining on the Mersey, just like that there. And then they'd know where to drop the bombs. And one of them came down, boot away. They say his ghost wanders around Alexandra Dock, dead scared. Talking all the time in German. But I remember thinking, the last thing you must have seen must have been dead lovely. All that moonlight gleaming on the Mersey, from up there in the sky.
Maybe he thought it was a place that was on his side.
It's all right. It's there. Come on. It's a good girl. Shh.
Do you really think I'm pretty? As pretty as Lorna?
Prettier.
Swear you'll never leave me until your ears wise and your legs won't carry you to church. God's truth.
I swear.
Bring me a fire, please. Amara, Lily Carmel. Arrived 1951, placed into Ashwood. And the little girl is?
15.
Not so little, then. Mr. Flynn, we don't usually allow these children out for adoption. You and your wife will have to pass some fairly stringent tests. We can't take any risks with the kiddies.
My wife and I have two children, 13 and 8. We're separated, about to be divorced.
Mr. Flynn.
And I know the rules. But I was hoping in this case you might be able to bend them. See, Lily is completely alone. She has absolutely no one to look after her. Well, I can offer her security. She wants to live with me.
We can't possibly allow a divorced man to adopt a 15-year-old girl.
No. No. But you can send her out to bloody whoop-whoop, can't you? To be treated like a slave and jumped on by every bloke that feels like it, because that's what's happened to her. How often do you check on these kids? How often do you ask if they're being treated all right?
Mr. Flynn, these children have already lost what most take for granted. They're orphans, or from poor homes, or broken homes. Dare I say it, Mr. Flynn, from homes like yours, children like yours, whose parents have simply walked away because they bloody well felt like it.
Where have you been?
tram or something?
Bastard!
Let me. Told you. Is that St. Pete's and you're going to help me find him?
How big is this bird? Is this big?
Same as me. Brown hair, blue eyes, and he's funny.
Bullshit!
Ellen Mary O'Mara. Born Dublin, 1970. Well, I can't adopt you if you've got a mother. Siblings, none. Father's name, unknown.
Why didn't you tell me the truth? Why didn't you bloody trust me?
Don't know what you're talking about.
I've seen your records. You haven't got a bloody brother.
Bert's not my brother, but he is real. I swear.
You swear? Swear till your hair's white and your legs won't carry you to church. Hmm? Yeah, because the blister's off your tongue.
Don't, Daddy! It's the truth. Scout's on it. I thought you'd look after us.
What?
Well, you said you'd look after me.
I've got two children of my own that I can't look after. I don't think I want another two hanging off me as well.
Will you stop drinking that stuff?
Piss off!
Are you gonna leave me too? You mum did. Like everybody else does. You said maybe one day I'd want to kiss someone back.
Billy! Bill!
Sorry. I got scared. Got scared I'd let you down. I drink too much, Lil. Lil, listen to me. If they wanted me to keep you, we'll work out another way. I'll marry you. If it's necessary, you know, if it comes to that.
I'm going to find Bert, Harry.
Don't leave me, Lou.
We're going somewhere that's on our side.
Is it on the trots?
Visitor Nesbitt says she's your sister.
See if you've built your skylon. Did you get me letters?
What letters?
I wrote every week, except once when I got a cane and my finger broke. Scouts on it.
Bastard O'Neill.
I brought you something. It's a bit soft. You're too old for it, really. Shrink ourselves, like in Gulliver's Travels. Remember? We'd be able to sail home in that. We'd have bunks. Wilson in the bottom one. So you'd be able to feel the engine humming. And this time, we'd stop and climb the pyramids. And we'd sail right up to the Mersey, to the Albert Dock, dead posh like. And there we'd be able to smell the water.
I'm staying here. I'm becoming a brother.
Don't be daft. You and me. Deaf aid. Home.
Listen, Wilson's dead. He drowned in there. He thought it was a swimming pool.
Excuse me, miss. There's no more trains tonight. Next one's not till 5:10. Where are you headed for?
I don't know.
father.
Miss Liss, there is a young gentleman who seems to need some help.
Yes, Mr. Hume.
they cost a month's rent each.
Too good for the likes of me, eh?
I'll give you shape bait, Nez, but see if I don't.
Fine.
Perhaps they say, you can't keep company, you know. They'll get me into strife. Have you looked for work?
Oh, yeah. Didn't I tell you I'm going to be a stockbroker?
You can't live on £5 a week forever, you know. They're 19 and sixpence.
I can't pay for them. I can't pay for any of this stuff.
I'll pay for them. Your feet stink so horrible. Have you had a bath today?
There you are. Have you forgotten it's Thursday?
Mrs. Campbell, do you think we'd be able to pay the other half next week? We've had a few expenses.
I got caught in the rain.
Looking for work, were you?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
So if you could wait, I might be able to get some overtime with the sale and all. And then I'll be able to pay up in advance.
Well, since it is coronation week, just this once. Till Thursday.
Thanks.
You'd better get yourself cleaned up. Fuck hell. Is that your
name? Be with me always. Take any form. Drive me mad. Only do not leave me in this abyss where I cannot find you. Oh God, it is all trouble. I cannot live without my life. I cannot live without my...
Oh, shite.
Where's the candles?
You know them pyramids? There was nothing inside them, but dead people. Sometimes they even shut up live servants in there. And when they ran out of food and water and air, they just die, starving to death and suffocating. Sometimes it took weeks for them to go, one by one. Some of them ate each other. But after a while, there was nothing. Nothing left but rotten, stinking, dead people.
Get around there, come on, hold it steady. Don't drop it, this one's mine.
We'll work a few hours overtime, we can.
Righto, get those spreaders out. Lucky we didn't drop that, eh, boy? That's going to be yours. Yeah.
There you go, son. You want something? Ought to be in school, shouldn't you?
Shut off.
What?
I said shut off.
You can't work unless you're in the union, son.
F, F, F space, J, J, J space, F, F, F space, J, J, J. Good, Lily. F, F, F space, J, J, J space.
Your sister's late, eh? Who's Gideon?
No one.
No. Is the Jewish nobody?
No. I don't know.
Gideon was the famous Hebrew warrior. You don't mind if I join you, hmm? Campbell sends me mad. Coronation this, coronation that. Coronation books, coronation medals. And now we are forced to eat special coronation dinner. I think I go out for the night. And who is she queen of? Huh? Queen of us? I don't think so. Queen of the people made slaves in her colonies? Or the poor in her own country? Who go hungry so the rich can feast? I tell you something. She's not my queen.
What are you on about? You old bald.
Mrs. Campbell has steak and kidney.
Please let him be here. Bert!
Bert! What did you come back for? I was gonna be a brother. They were gonna look after me. I was gonna be somebody.
They've knocked the shine stuffing out of you. That's what they've done. There's no one else, Bertie. There's no one to look after you except me now. But I can't do it on my own. You have to look after me too. If you don't, I've got none. I've got nothing in this world. Be dead inside, Bertie. Run out if you keep that up. Some of my heart.
...1954. 3 years. I am in Australia. Lohan.
Lohan.
Don't tell Mr. Menzies I have Russian vodka. Oh, he throws me into jail. This is a good joke, isn't it? To Mrs. Campbell, I am reformed Nazi. To Mr. Menzies, dangerous red. To Bert, I am a butt. And to myself, I am Australian. To Australia.
To flippin' Australia.
Yeah. I have no more of war, no more of factories and shelters, no more of that camp, that number. Here I have no more of red flags and rallies. And blood.
I used to be Red 4.
No. That we're Australians. We forget, huh? Come on. I'll show you dance from my country, okay?
Jeszcze jeden mazur dzisiaj, choć poranek świta. Czy pozwoli pan na Krysia, młody ułan pyta.
I niedługo błaga, prosi, bądź to z polskiej ziemi.
I do tańca ją unosi, a stopar za niemi. I do tańca ją unosi, a stopar za niemi.
So Mrs. Campbell thinks I am a Nazi, eh? And you are brother and sister. This is the best joke. To Australia.
Madam, that's what you're supposed to put. My name is Albert Winston Nesbitt. I was sent to Australia in 1951. I am trying to find my mother and father or a relative. My mother's name was Martha Elizabeth Kelly, and my father's Christian name was... Are you sure it's Gideon?
It's Jewish.
I don't think the Catholics were allowed to marry Jews. They don't believe in Jesus, do they?
Well, I don't care.
The Jews are the oldest people. They were slaves, right? But Moses made the Pharaoh let them go. And the Red Sea rolled back like that and parted right down the middle for them.
How do you know all this?
Pavel told me.
He's not one, is he?
No. But he could have married one.
Well, where is she then?
Don't know. Then he told. The brothers used to say that the Jews killed Jesus. But Pavel says the dead special. They built the pyramid, you know. What's the funny?
I thought your mum and dad were spies in Germany.
With all them Nazis. You're soft.
She used to boast. 5'2", eyes are blue. Except hers were brown. I've tried concentrating, but it just turns all fuzzy and yellow. She's gone, Bertie. I can't see it in my head. I can't remember a face.
Shove over. Here we go. Here comes the plane. It's over Southport. And Bundle Sands. Yeah. It's over Kirkby. And Bootle. And Scotty. It's going over Greaty Market. And now it's coming in. Right over Gerrard Gardens. Nice.
I want to join the union.
You're a bit of a runt. What's your name?
Bert Lester.
Banger O'Toole. You know what they say about warpies, mate? Harden the muscles, soften the brain.
I've got the soft bit of it.
Tell you something else about warpies. They're the bottom of the heap. Up top there's the bosses, there's the foreman, down below there's us.
Down below the pimp show line?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Boys, this is Bert. Larry, Purse, Sykes, Singlet.
Singlet?
Yeah, he's never off his back. That's O-boy.
O-boy.
Bert wants to join up. We'll see how he goes, eh?
You want a cup of tea?
Yeah.
It's a mug's life. Bunga there's a union delegate. You can't get away with nothing.
Yeah, Bert. Lugs up. Brand towards you. All right. There you go.
What is it?
Soda rash. The worst job on the waterfront.
£5 up front, £5 later. And there's no promise of work straight up. Nominator and seconder?
Bunga O'Toole and O'Boy.
Known him for 5 years, have you, O'Boy?
Yeah, they went to school together.
5 years, school, O'Boy.
Name and address, date of birth. Give it here. Name?
Lester.
I'm in Bunga's gang. He says I can be their mascot and all. Every litter's got to have a runt. And I'm it.
Mrs. Campbell said there'd be a dirty great storm later. It might even hail.
It'll be hailing lumps of steak and kidney if it does.
The eighth wonder of the world. You've got to kiss me. And afterwards, I've got to wash myself out. The little goblin's eyes were drooping, and the elves' tiny hands could not hide their yawns. The first white streaks of dawn, creeping in from the east, the cowslips and the rhododendrons opened wide their petal doors and welcomed home their happy, sleepy children. The end. I swear I'll never leave you, Bertie. Not until my hair's white and my legs won't carry me to church.
God's truth.
God's truth.
The Dominion tour went on as scheduled, and the royal couple were treated to the colourful spectacle of Maori ceremonial dancers. Elizabeth was presented with a hand-woven cape, and then Maori women went through their striking and melodious song and paddle routine, canoe poi. The task of presenting to the Queen a bouquet of frangipani and orchids. Just watch this curtsy. Then to Tonga to repay the visit by Queen Salote to the coronation. A fabulous feast, prepared and eaten according to the island customs. A sucking pig fit for a queen. Next port of call for the Gothic was Auckland.
Now, comrades, I've got nothing against the Queen herself. You know, nothing personal. In fact, for a pom, she's not a bad-looking sort.
She speaks well of you, bunger.
But what she represents, and what all monarchies represent, is centuries of oppression by the haves over the have-nots. Centuries of crimes against the poor and the ignorant. Centuries of stuffing pheasant down the mouths of the ruling classes by bleeding the workers dry, and we say no more bleeding. And if there is going to be bleeding, it will not be workers' blood. And in the words, comrades, of Henry Lawson, we must fly a rebel flag, as others did before us. We must sing a rebel song and join in rebel chorus. We'll make those tyrants feel the sting of those that they will throttle, and they needn't say the fault is ours when there's blood upon the waddle. And there will be blood upon the waddle, and it will be the blood of the bloody ruling class, and it will be the communist party.
Better me, we're Republicans.
You're a Republican, you're sodden biffle.
Communist party and the ruling class.
In Australia, we think things will be different. Nothing changes.
Go on, read it, read it.
Star of the Sea Orphanage, Liverpool, England, 12th of January, 1954. Dear Albert Nesbitt, read your letter of January the 5th. We have checked our records, which indicate that you are placed in care here at Star of the Sea at the age of 3 years by your mother, Martha Elizabeth Kelly. It seems the same Martha Kelly visited once some 18 months later, had a discussion about removing you from Star, but apparently decided in the negative as she did not reappear. She left no forwarding address. We have no record of father's name. I apologize that I am unable to provide more details. Yours sincerely, Margaret Lane.
Where did that come from, do you think? Moses. Or the Pharaoh. Or some poor bitch making a living in the gutter somewhere.
You belong to me now. I'm your family.
You're not supposed to fuck your sister.
Say cheese to our Betty, eh? Don't forget to curtsy.
In the great white ship, riding at anchor, royal as a swan, is the queen we have never seen.
What's she ever done for you?
Read it, soldier!
Today is holiday. No waiting today.
Read it!
Don't be stupid. Dear Ellen O'Mara, I have seen your notice in the newspaper and hope see you soon. When I found out you were here, I was not sure I should see you. I am not the same person you left behind, and have gotten used to thinking that I don't have a mother or a family like other people do, and to wondering if you had to leave or if it was what you really wanted. But I don't think my life can stay as it is for very much longer. And if you can help me, then perhaps it is time for us to meet.
You're no ghost. You got out.
Thank you.
Not just me, you know. You've got two kids now.
What were you going to do? Stab the Queen? Assault her with this?
Maybe.
How far did you think you'd get? Charge him with causing a public nuisance.
I wanted to hear the Queen, you know. I wanted to see her blood on the wattle.
Ryan, come on, lift that as it is. Come on, you stragglers.
Look, are you sure you want me to?
Please.
All right, you up the back, son. Lift those knees. Come on, get those arms pumping. Pump that blood. Come on, lift those knees. Pump that blood. Come on, get in the front, boys. Lift those knees. Come on. Now get fit, you boys. Come on.
They're making me do woodwork. They're trying to make a carpenter out of me. But I said I'm going back to the docks. I don't care what they say.
I'm in the office of Foy's now, Bertie. I'm secretary to the sales manager.
Lady Moore, you look dead grown up.
Mum remembers you. From Star.
It's not me.
Of course it's you.
Him. There. Him. He was president of the club. People would listen to him. Laugh at his stories. He didn't know he was bottom of the heap.
We found a flat, Mum and me. It's not like Gerald Gardens or nothing. It's got three rooms.
You're always going on about Gerald Gardens like it was that special.
It's a dump. dream. But being at a place that was on our side.
I've got to go. Teaching me to read proper.
Try.
Look. You don't have to keep coming back. It's a long way for you.
I'll never forget you. My hair's white, and my legs won't carry me to church. That's God's truth.
I wonder what the apathy of wealthy men endure. We're all lay windows level with the faces of the poor. Ah, mammon's slaves, your knees shall knock, your hearts in terror beat. And God demands a reason for the sorrows of the street. The wrong things and the bad things and the sad things that we meet in the filthy lane and alley. And a cruel, heartless street.
As soon as you're born, they make you feel small by giving you no time instead of it all. Till the pain is so big you feel nothing at all. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. They hurt you at home and they hit you at school. They hate you if you're clever, and they despise a fool. Till you're so fucking crazy you can't follow their rules. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. When they've tortured and scared you for 20-odd years, then they expect you to pick a career. When you can't really function, you're so full of fear. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. keep you doped with religion and sex and TV. And you think you're so clever and classless and free, but you're still fucking peasants as far as I can see. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. There's room at the top, they are telling you still. But first you must learn how to smile as you kill. You want to be like the folks on the hill. A working class hero is something to be. A working class hero is something to be. If you want to be a hero, well, just follow me. If you want to be a hero, well, just follow me.